Hi, I'm Kirt Jacobs, host and creator of Moxie Talk, and we're at the Idea Festival today with Twyman Clements. He's the president and CEO of Space Tango. Twyman, welcome.
Yeah, thank you very much. I've been coming to this for several years now, so it's always great to come to Louisville and spend the week here.
That's great having you here. So what have you gotten out of this year's Idea Festival, and how has it impacted you?
Yeah, only been here a couple of days. Actually, unfortunately, missed the first day. It's just the diversity of both the speakers and the students and the attendees. You get people who are plumbers to rocket scientists to classical musicians, all different types of things. So it's really the mold, kind of the melting of all the ideas and the people together. Yeah,
that's great. Twyman, what has inspired you on your career path?
It's odd. It's kind of a combination of just being a space geek. I grew up on a farm in Bardstown, Kentucky. I have three brothers. We all built rockets and launched them. So it was that part, and then also kind of the medical, some of the things we've done on the medical side and the exomedicine side that are a combination of two of my interests that make the job a lot of fun day to day. And as we're kind of building our products and becoming more successful, as we go along that vision of what Space Tango is really trying to do.
That's great. Now, this next question is in terms of your vision for the future, your dream. It's called the dream question, in my opinion. In your ideal vision, 40, 50 years from now, what would that look like for a future generation?
I think one of my favorite books is called The Firecracker Boys, and it's actually about using hydrogen bombs to do large-scale civil engineering projects. The reason it's one of my favorites is because it paints a picture of the early 50s and late 50s of using nuclear power, and it was going to end wars, and poverty was going to be gone, and all these other things. And what it showed was really the overpromise of a technology. And so I'm always hesitant about this, of taking our current technologies and extrapolating them forward, because we never quite know what happened. So I think, for the next 40 or 50 years, I think my goal or my dream would be, I think what a lot of people's would be, is of a little bit more equality in the world in terms of wealth, with certain parts of the world, rising, more people rising up to the middle class, disease, other things like that, so that more lives in the world can reach their full potential. I think that's the biggest thing. I know that's a little generic, but I think that's the best goal we can have in the next 50 years.
Twyman, this next question has to do with your industry of space. What do you see on the horizon in the future that you're really excited about?
Yeah, so what's really fun about this, technologies build on technologies, and they build on when certain technologies become mature, new things can develop. And so a lot of the news that's happened in the space industry, broadly defined over the last couple of years, is really the launch side of the equation. Reusability, better access to space, things like that. And so Space Tango as a company needs that to exist to for us to flourish. And so we're kind of the use case side of the equation. And that's the exciting thing, and I think that's the future of the next couple of years, is really developing the use cases. We now have the transport technologies that are becoming more regular and lower cost and things like that. And that enables new companies to come in that can raise smaller amounts of money. They don't need tens of millions, hundreds of millions, billions of dollars to get going. That's the really fun part. I mean, we're riding that wave, but there's other people that are doing that as well. Yeah.
Now, this next question is called our legacy question, and we have a more longer form type of interview that we do traditionally. When the great day comes, Twyman, God forbid it all ended today. You walk out of the Idea Festival. Sure. It's your last day on Earth. How do you want to be remembered?
Yeah. That's a tough one. So I'll go back. Credit to my dad, King Clements. So this was 12 years ago when I was graduating high school. I was getting your senior quote together, and he suggested the Theodore Roosevelt in the arena quote, which I can't do verbatim right now. Yeah, do verbatim right now. I think to be remembered, again, this is a little bit general, but that you were in the arena. That you really committed to what you were trying to do. You battled, you had blood on your blood and mud and everything else on your face, and that you were in the arena, you really tried. I think that's the best you can have, is that you were in there really trying to do what you make a difference, build a company, improve lives, things like that. I think that would have to be it.
I think that says a lot about your character, picking the man in the arena. That was Theodore Roosevelt, early 1900s. Mm-hmm. Twyman, quite a pleasure having you on Moxie Talk. Thanks for being at Idea Festival.
Yeah, thanks.
Twyman, I bet the audience is very curious to know the meaning behind Space Tango. Could you tell us about that, please?
Yeah, sure. So was appointed CEO about 3 years ago. And actually, the company at that time was called E10 Space, E with a superscript 10. And when you explain it to somebody, they'd always say Eaton Space, or they'd never really hear it correctly. And I didn't like it. Our chairman and the people who appointed me, I went to him and I just said, I don't like the name. Can we rename the company? And this was, we were still very embryonic, still very much growing. At the time, we were actually the Kentucky Science and Technology Corporation, which does Idea Festival where we're at here, was doing a space accelerator for businesses. And that accelerator was called Space Tango. And people kept getting them all, the two companies, confused. And the accelerator was named Space Tango because building a company is like a dance, and so we, you know, tango really went well together, and so people kept getting it confused. So we said, well, let's just use that for the name, and so it stuck. And it took a while. It actually wore on me a little bit, but it's really kind of a lot of people like it. A lot of people complimented us on it. They like the bright red, things like that. So it was kind of a mistake. It was kind of a they gave me a day to come up with a new name, and so that's what we went with.
I think that's a wicked go ahead.
Yeah, and the name stuck. So
that's great. I figured there was a wicked answer to that, so thanks so much.